This is part two of the Yamaha R5C rebuild or restoration. And as you can see, I've got the parts painted. All nice and shiny. Beautiful. And I got the frame. I rebuilt the steering head. It's all nice and pretty and beautiful. Using the vinegar acid approach to the nuts and bolts, they sure do look nice against that black. And I've taken the forks apart. And I'm having a real problem because you can see there's a little pitting. And I'm gonna have to live with that one. If it leaks, it leaks. But this one's gone. I mean, I cleaned and cleaned. I got all the rust off. But with all the rust came all the chrome. I'll be able to polish these fork legs without any problem at all. They're gonna look brand new. And all the other parts look great. There's a little bit of etching. I don't know if you can see it, but it's corroded a little bit, but the clip is still good. But this fork leg, this fork tube, oh my god, the people on eBay, they want $700 or so for two new ones. And I'm going to end up just putting it back together because I just drive to bike night. And I'll even leave the old fork seals in there because I'm not going to put but maybe a couple ounces of oil in the bottom just to keep it lubricated. You pull the covers, you know, and that's it. That's all I can do. I mean, you know, you get crazy with these bikes, and I'll wait for a single fork tube. And then I'll put it in. You know, if I have the bike long enough, I'll do that and go from there. Talk to you later. This is going to be the first time for me to lace a wheel, because these spokes are just too bad. I've cleaned them up before, but only because I didn't want to have to learn how to do the lacing process. Bearing's good. And these really weren't that rusted. Some of them, from what I understand, you have to actually cut the spoke. So there it is. Gonna go for a new set of spokes. It's always a question of how far I want to take the polishing. As you can see, you know, this has got like a big gouge right there. And it's just not gonna clean up with a little soap and water. So the other hub was just like it. You know, and I don't want that mirror finish. I really want it to look like it's an original, you know, like it came out of an NOS box or something. But there's really no way. I've looked around and I've got to get in here. That's what it looked like. And then that's where I got it. And I think that's good. I think that's as close to stock as I'm going to get. And I'm afraid if I do a wheel, a regular polishing wheel, that I'm going to get it to look like. Get it to look like that.
which is what I did with the KZ Cafe Racer, but
I don't really want that. I just want it to look stock, and so doing it by hand, I think I'll put up with a little bit of, you know, pitting and a little bit of scratching just to get that look from that. And then the rim, of course, is chrome. I worked on this for a long time. In here, I got as much rust as I could out of the rim. There's still a lot in there. And I'll probably work on it for another hour. But all in all, it's pretty nice. And all the rust is off. It's just shiny. And it'll look great. New spokes on that hub. It's gonna look great. Yep. Gonna have to do the same thing with this one. But the inside, much nicer. Just a little bit of surface rust, nothing big. And, you know, it's pretty filthy. And to get it to look like this, that's what I'm trying to do. The first thing is to work on the brake area here. I got most of the rust off, the heavier parts. This is what it looked like before, and this is after, and it's quite a difference. And what it is this is what I use for brake calipers, actually, for the, you know, the piston and the caliper when they get rusty and corroded. And what this is it's a rubber wheel. I ended up having to buy like 100 of them, you know, and probably I'll use less than one a year. They don't really go away that fast. This one's, because it's such a big area, it's not a caliper. The caliper doesn't have much area, but you know, and it's got rubber with a little bit of diamond or some sort of abrasive in it, and boy, it really works well. You just spin it up and give it a back and forth motion, and I'll see if I can get this to do a little bit for you. So just wipe it out. You can see how it takes the rust out, and it'll be plenty good for this old bike. You know, just getting it like, you know, non-rusty and just smooth. That's all. And then I worked on the outer ring here, so we're getting closer. It must be upside down. There we go. I've got the first set of spokes on, and this R5 had some real rusty spokes, but I found this kit. And it comes from Thailand. It was on eBay. It's like $50. Gave me all the spokes for the front and rear. for an R5. What a deal. And they really are beautiful quality. So I'll show it to you when we've got the whole wheel laced. And again, this is my first wheel lacing. Well, it's all together. And boy, these spokes are beautiful. What a great kit. And I've got, although it's my first time, that's about as close as I can get it. Right here is a weld. I'm sure where they welded the rim together, there's a little dip right there. So I, you know, kind of have to live with that. But now, it's all together. And I don't really have any wobble, or it had a lot, but I adjusted the spokes just like you would do, and that's all on YouTube. And now there's hundreds of videos on how to do a relacing and how to true the wheel, but sure is looking pretty. Starting on the rear now, got the rim all polished, got the first two spokes in. So we've got half the spokes plus a few in here already, and there's a guy online, a real nice southern gentleman, that calls them heads or tails, and that's because the head or tail. So he basically puts all the heads in first, and the tails, you'll see where there's a little place where that spoke made a mark. And it'll be every other one. Every other one. You'll see there's another mark right there. Right there where the spoke runs out this way. Runs out like that. So that's the second set of spokes. Every other hole. And one thing that he did mention was if it's a brand new hub, it doesn't matter where you start. You know, you do the both sides of the heads, which is through and out, and then every fourth hole you'll do the next one, every fourth hole. So you get all of the first run of heads, then flip it over and do the other set of heads on the other side. And then start the tails like I'm doing here. You pull it up and you see where that mark is. It dictates what angle it's going at. And then you can see right on the hub, that's the natural hole for it. It's the angle is right. It's angling back at me here and towards the spoke. Or this one is angling back at me, but it's going forward. So, we're close. All right, so both of them are laced, front and rear. Let's do the little spoke test here. Sound pretty good. Yeah, and it's really close. Near perfect. So I'm sure that everything will be just perfect. On to mounting the front end. Here is the beginning of reassembling the front end and the forks. Here's one pass with the black rouge on the polishing wheel. That's what it looked like before. So I think, I try not to get that mirror finish. I don't want a mirror finish, although it's hard not to get that. I just think the mirror finish looks too custom. I'd really rather have a brand new fork leg, but I can't afford those either. So anyhow, I'm going to take one more pass with the brown rouge, and hopefully it won't get too shiny. All right, it's pretty much what I want. There's a scratch right there, but it isn't coming out. But you can see it just kind of cleans it up. A little clean, pretty clean compared to that. And this one will actually come out better. And there's a nice gash there too. But this one was the roughest one, and it had the sticker on it, and I can still see the line. See, there's a line right there. I could probably buff that out, but you know, then it gets too shiny, and then it's almost like, I know this almost looks original, although it really isn't. That's really what it should look like, only, you know, like in here, clean and like brand new. But you do what you have to do. Getting them polished out a little keeps it clean, makes it look nice. So now starts the process of stripping the paint. Still working on the forks, but gotta make use of this nice weather out here, because it's been terrible for so long. But starting with the paint stripper. This seems like a good place to end the first part. And pick it back up when we put the whole rolling frame together. We got everything set up here. It's all mounted. Everything's in its proper place. Got the, just reuse the old brake shoes. And I greased up the speedometer. And took me a little time to figure out exactly where the arms went. But there they are. So now the next thing is to just get the tire on the front, get the front wheel on the bike, get the rear swing arm, rear wheel, and tire and handlebars so the thing can be pushed around. And then next, I'm going to be detailing the motor. I used the paint stripper, and it's really clean, really, really clean. It's going to take to paint well. This part here, the main case, stays natural, just, you know, it doesn't get painted, but the side is black. And then what I did is I polished these ribs. I don't know if you can see it, but what I'm after is almost like a factory look. Once it's painted, then this should look like a new side cover. It'll be that particular black. But how I get that to not be too shiny and almost have a grain in it is I use 400 grit sandpaper or 600 and get a kind of a fine line in there. And I don't know if you can see it, but if you get a fine line and then take like 1500 and go over it and then a little bit of polish, not much. I've got to do the same with this. I'm going to polish this ring right here. But that's what it looks like before.
And that's what it looks like after. And I do that before it's painted.
And then just mask it off. And that is kind of the next direction. After we get a rolling chassis, we're going to put the motor in the frame. And we will see you on the next video.